Actually, the snow right now is not abnormal at all. What we've seen over the past couple of years is that, snow can vary month to month, and over the past few winters, yeah, we've seen a lot of snow, but this year there's not much snow, but it's not by far the least amount of snow that we've had. 2006 had less snow, and as we would recall, in 2010 we had quite a bit of snow. So it's really not abnormal. It's just the global cycle working together. There's lots of impacts for not having enough snow. Snow is actually quite an important part of the water cycle. When snow falls, it lands in snowpacks and it stays there. It's like a battery, and it holds the energy of that snow. It holds that water so that when it melts out in the spring and the summer, we can use that for water resources. If we get less snow, that means that it melts earlier. And also, there's an issue with if it melts, it makes that the earth, which is typically reflective when there's snow cover, it's like a mirror, it allows it to absorb more heat. So we really want to have as much snow as we can for our normal cycles. Yeah, there are a couple factors that NASA researchers are just they've recently uncovered. One of the big things for the snow began in 2010 was that we were in an El Niño year. And what that means, it's a lot of moisture from the Pacific Ocean was uplifted and brought over the U.S. And what happens there is that then it's deposited in the southeast U.S. Some of that moisture came up the East Coast. And then what we had another factor, which is called the North Atlantic Oscillation. And in 2010, it was persistently negative. And really, what that means is that there was a high pressure system over the polar regions that was pushing cold air down. So the interacting moisture from the Pacific Ocean with the cold air from the Arctic, what happens then is we get snow. And we had a lot of snow in 2010. There's many reasons to study snow from space. I mean, sure, you can go out in your backyard or you can use your radars to measure it from space, but over the oceans, there's no way to measure the snow. When you measure snow from space, you can get uniform measurements that can be applied globally and also can be used in models for better forecasting for weather and for better forecasting of the climate change and how are we going to predict climate change. NASA's doing some great things right now to understand winter storm mechanics. We have a field campaign going on right now, which is in the January time period of 2012. We've got an aircraft called the DC-8, which many of you might have flown on, and I was actually on last week. And this aircraft is flying over the tops of the snow clouds over southern Ontario. And with it, we're also measuring some other information with other spiraling aircraft. And we put all this information together to get a three-dimensional structure of the snow. We're going to use that for global precipitation measurement, which is a satellite that's going to be launched in 2014. And this satellite is going to provide us everything from the heavy tropical rain you might see in hurricanes all the way through the snow. And the information we're getting right now is going to help improve those models and help improve our forecasting in the future.